Good morning, guys, and welcome to OCD Details in Lincoln. Something a little bit special this morning, a brand new John Cooper Works Mini, direct from Park Lane, London. This is coming in for coatings, so our Ceramic Pro Silver package. So wheels off, paint coated, paint polished, plastics coated, wheels coated, calipers coated, arches cleaned out, full decon, etc. Windows coated as well. And then we'll give the interior a little tickle. I just wanted to show you basically the condition the car has come in. Being a brand new car, I think it's got around 8 miles on the clock currently. The owner has had it over the weekend and has been out in it, so it might be a bit more now. As you can see, looks great, but without the lights on it. Got my trusty torch. I'm going to take you in for some closer shots. So, as you can see, looks fantastic in the right light. So let me bring you in here. Gonna bring the good old trusty torch in. So we've got quite a bit of wash marring and swirls all down the side there. Again, on the roof, exact same thing. And just along here, we've actually got some polishing marks. There you go. So that has been previously been machine polished. That would have been from factory. Not the greatest of work, but that's what you expect with new cars. Again, bringing you in onto the bonnet. Same finish. It's basically just wash marring. Whether the dealer washed it, I'm not sure. Got a nice bird trail there, or a bug trail, one or the other. And yeah, there we go, some B pillar or A pillar nastiness. Again, roof all the way down the side of the car. Plastics already starting to fade, so we'll treat them. The rear isn't too bad. The lovely wheels. I do like these wheels. They suit the car so well. And the big brakes are well suited as well. So yeah, that is the JCW. I'm going to basically film for the first time on my own the full process, start to finish. Hopefully it turns out all right. If it doesn't, you'll probably not see this. I thought it'd just be a bit of a change from the regular photos, you know, 60 plus photos. There will be photos, but I might not post them. Video seems to be the way forward these days. So yeah, enjoy, and thank you very much for watching.
The power to dream at night any dream you wanted to dream. And you would, of course, be able to alter your time sense and slip, say, 75 years of subjective time into 8 hours of sleep. We'll be right back. you could design for yourself what would be the most ecstatic life. Love affairs, banquets, dancing girls, wonderful journeys, gardens, music beyond belief. And then after a couple of months of this sort of thing, at 75 years a night, you'll be getting a little taste for something different. And you would move over to an adventurous dimension. Well, there were certain dangers involved and the thrill of dealing with dangers. And you could rescue princesses from dragons and go on dangerous journeys. Make wonderful explosions and blow.
We have deconned the arches. I've not bothered cleaning the wheels because as soon as I go in, car gets dried and I basically pull it on the ramp and take the wheels off, come straight back outside and then give the wheels a good clean inside and out, dry them off, ready for coatings on Wednesday, and then I steam clean the brakes and any missed details, usually on the inners of the springs is quite a common one. General, get everything off it as I can outside without taking the wheels off. They go high enough to be able to get all the arches anyway. It hasn't got enough miles on it to be absolutely caked, so I have no issue in not taking the wheels off out here at all. Next, we're going to pre-wash and snow foam. It'll just be snow foam, which, yeah, it's just a single stage pre-wash as such. It's not dirty enough to go any further. It's not covered in crap, etc. I'm going to put some bug remover on just to get rid of those organic matters on the front. And then do the full wash process, decon, clay if needed. If it's not needed, I'll just go over it with a mitt. They're more than adequate on a new car. There's no need to go heavier than a mitt, i.e. clay bars. I do have a clay puck, I think they call them, from Carbon Collective. So yeah, on with the wash stage.
Come up. Eventually get into contest with them. For some time, you'll think up a new wrinkle to forget that you were dreaming, so that you would think it was all for real and to be anxious about it. And then, because it'd be so great when you woke up, and then you say, well, like children who dare each other on things, how far out could you get? Of abandonment of your power. What dimension of that could you stand? You could ask yourself this because you know you'd eventually wake up. And after you'd gone on doing this, you see, for some time, you would suddenly find yourselves sitting around in this room with all your personal involvement, problems, etc., talking with me. How do you know that's not what you're doing? Could be. Because after all, what would you do if you were God? If you were what there is, the self.
So we've done the contact wash. So pre-wash, wheels, arches cleaned, not fully on the wheels because we're going to take them off when it goes inside and then we'll pull them out. You can't get into the barrels on the front of these. There's literally probably 5 mil of gap and I don't have anything that will get in there, but they will be coming off. Now is time for decon, so tar and fallout remover. I'm going to be using Infinity Wax's liquid fire fallout remover. This will turn ferrous materials into liquids, so Fe3 or Fe2 into Fe3, so solid into a liquid, and then we can rinse it off. It does turn red. It doesn't smell anything like any other products I've used, which is great. So you don't stink yourself out. So yeah, onto the decon wash.
When asked who is there, says it is I, and thereafter gives whatever particular name he may have. For if you were God.
So we have the iron remover on. I have put a layer of snow foam over the top just to stop it drying out. It's quite a warm morning. The last thing I want to happen is the product to dry out on the car. So a very light watery, it's quite a thick snow foam. It just helps the fallout stay on longer and keep wet to do its job, as well as dragging any contaminants down the car as needed before we rinse it off. So we've done the fallout remover, got rid of all the fallout. Now going to use tar and glue, get rid of any tar spots. I haven't seen any, but just in case, always good practice to do the full decon regardless if you think you need it or not.
And in the sense that you knew everything and you were completely transparent to yourself through and through.
And quick top tip, if you have a lot of tar on the car, dry it first and the product will work better. With this, I have no issues putting it on wet because I haven't seen any tar. Any tar that is there will just get taken off anyway because it's so minute.
You would be bored, because if looking at it from another way, we push technology to its furthest possible development, and we had, instead of a dial telephone on one's desk, a more complex system of buttons, and one touch feet would give you anything you want. Aladdin's lamp.
I'm going to let that dwell for a couple of minutes and then I'll just rinse it off. There's no point in me wiping it down with a microfiber or anything like that. It's just one extra step and potential for dust to fall on the car and you're going to scrape the car or scratch the car. Again, it hasn't got enough tar. I haven't seen any, full stop. So if there is any, it's gonna jet wash off. The chemicals are really strong and their purpose is to remove tar. So yeah, crack on.
You would eventually have to introduce a button labeled.
So, I'm going to use the 3M Claymit. I think it's a medium grade. I just don't want to use a fine grade if there is something on there. I'd rather have it off than getting transferred through the pad when I'm machine polishing. It's not going to do any more damage than what's already on the car, purely because the pressure is spread out so on such a large area compared to your clay. You've got a whole, like, the risk of doing any more damage is practically none. It's a bit like balancing a pin on an orange and pushing it. That sort of pressure, it's going to go straight in. But if you balance the same pin on, or a bigger pin on the same orange, it's not going to go through because there's such a big surface area where the pressure is distributed. So yeah, we'll crack on with the claim.
Surprise. Because all perfectly known futures, as I pointed out, are past. They have happened, virtually. It is only the true future is a surprise.
Decon, clay, etc. Finally done the last wash, so it's pretty much a 9-step process for me at least. I'm now going to dry off the vehicle before I bring it in, just to stop moisture getting in the unit and obviously making the unit humid. It is warm, it's cloudy, but it is warm. I'm going to be using the Bristol Detailing Supplies Ultra Plush cloth or drying towel. I think these are 18 quid, so if you want one, go hit them up on bristoldetailingsupplies.co.uk or Crystal Clear Polishing in Bristol. Daryl will sort you out, or the boys will. Again, products as well, they do everything you need. Down that end, I sell them here. Good friends, good products. So yeah, onto the drying.
So if you were God, you would say to yourself, man, get lost. And it's strange.
So, that is the decon wash done, ready to go inside, dried it off. So we'll pull it inside, get the wheels off, bring them out, fully decon them, dry them, get them ready for coating, and we'll start the machine polishing.
That this idea is obscurely embedded in the Christian tradition, when in the Epistle to the Philippians, St. Paul speaks of God the Son, the Logos, the Word of God, who is incarnate in Christ, and says, let this mind be in you which was also in Christ Jesus, who, being in the form of God, thought not equality with God a thing to be clung to, but made himself of no reputation, and humbled himself, and was found in fashion as a man, and became obedient to death. Same idea. Same idea as the idea of the dream. You get that very far out reach. Getting as extreme as you can get. And so this then is the basis of the Hindu view of the universe and of man. The Hindu looks upon the universe as a drama. The Westerner, of course, looks upon the universe as a construct, as something made. And it is not, therefore, insignificant that Jesus was the son of a carpenter. The Chinese looks upon the universe as an organism, as we shall subsequently see. But the dramatic idea is basic to Hinduism. Now, you can speak about Hinduism on two levels, at least.
So, you just see me do the first wheel. I didn't need a tar remover, it had nothing on it. I double checked that. Again, I'm not going to bore you with all four wheels, I'm just going to blast through them. And then we'll get in, dry all the crevices out with the big boy blower, just to get any water off the car. And then we'll start the polishing process.
One I will call the metaphysical level, and the other the mythological level. If you speak on the metaphysical level, you can speak only in negative language. You can say what the divine, the ultimate reality, is not. If you speak on the mythological level, you may speak of what the divine is like. Because myth is not a falsehood, as one uses the word in a sophisticated way. A myth is an image, a concrete image, in terms of which man makes sense of the world. And thus the idea of God the Father or God the Maker is a myth, because it's an image. And Christian theologians distinguish equally between two kinds of theological language, which are respectively called cataphatic and apophatic. Apophatic language is negative, as when we say God is infinite. Cataphatic language is mythological. When we say God's the Father, God is love, and all the positive designations. They're not saying God is a cosmic male pearl, but is analogous with the Father. Illusion is related to the Latin ludere. And that means play. And this is why the analogy of the world is dramatic. It's a play. In the sense of a stage.
So, just use some all-purpose cleaner along with the Kartra steam cleaner, just for the brakes, the face of the disc, and then just to catch any slight dirt that's been picked up. So I'm finished with all the prep. It's been washed, deconed, etc., etc. Wheels are off. They've been deconed, dried. Brakes again, washed and dried. Arches re-cleaned just to get any surface dirt off them. I've taped up all the delicate areas that need to be done, and I'm now going to basically prep the surface, double check for any major defects. I'm going to be using Infinity Wax's Synergy Prep. It's just an alcohol panel wipe. I think it's 18 quid for 5 litres, so I'd highly recommend it. I prefer it over the Car Pro stuff. So yeah, I'm gonna whiz around with the prep and then go around with the torch again, double check I've not missed any major defects before we start polishing.
Stage play. Now, when you go to the theater, you know what you're going to see is not for real. Because the proscenium arch tells you that.
Basically, I'm going to do a couple of test spots and see where we are with it, really. It is only in for a single stage. If I need to go any further with it, I will do. It's a new car, so it's not going to take much, hopefully. Don't know how these react so far. I am going to basically use Kartex 9000 and their white pad to begin with and go from there. So I've polished and refined the roof just to get that out of the way. It saves me moving the ramp up and down constantly. I can just work away around the middle half of the car now. I have done this panel here. I've just done a cutting stage. As you can see, far better. And then this is before. Bit better. I'm now going to start tackling this just here. That's going to be quite interesting to see if I can get that mark out. Need to be careful along here. It's showing signs of being quite thin. But yeah, so far so good. On with the rest of the vehicle. Good morning, guys. Day two on the JCW. I still need to do all the polishing on the bodywork itself. The roof is done, ready to go. So yeah, I'm going to whiz round. I'll probably just put in a time lapse because you don't want to just see a full half hour video of polishing, I guess. And yeah, I'll come back when we're going to do the primer and then the coatings, and you'll see that whole process.
But everything that happens on the far side of that arch is only in play, not serious. But the actor, and you will hope that he will be good at it, is going to try and persuade you that it's for real. So that he will so move you that you are crying or sitting in anxiety upon the edge of your chair. So the audience is almost persuaded to be taken in. Now, what about if this would happen to the very best actor of all, the great actor? The audience would, of course, be completely taken in. But in this case, of course, the actor and the audience are the same. The self. And St. Thomas, aware of this, said that the divine wisdom was above all to be compared with games, because games are played for their own sake and not for any sort of ulterior motive. so also music is a kind of non-purposive thing, because you don't either play music to reach a destination, nor do you dance to reach a particular place on the floor. It is the doing of it itself that is important, because after all, if the object of music were to gain a certain destination, those orchestras that played fastest would be considered the best. So the idea is that that dancing and music, more than other arts, represent the nature of this world. That it is playful, that it is sport. That it may be sincere, but is definitely not serious. G.K. Chesterton well put it once, the angels fly because they take themselves lightly.
So, I've just cut this area, included inside the door handle. Had to take the pad off just to get underneath the actual handle itself. But yeah, looking good. This is before, and this is after.
So if a beautiful lady should say to me, I love you, and I were to reply, are you serious or are you just playing with me? That would be quite the wrong response, because I hope she's not serious and that she will play with me. I should say, are you sincere or are you just toying with me? Because you see, the word play has many different senses. A person who is playing the organ in church is certainly not doing something trivial. When you go to see a play called Hamlet, you're not seeing something trivial. When the concert artist plays Mozart, he is certainly entertaining you, but it's not a trivial entertainment. But on the other hand, we would use play in quite a...
So, I'm just going to go around with the 1-inch, getting all the basically the hard areas where the big 3-inch or 5-inch pad isn't going to sit. Obviously, I don't want to be putting that pad there when I can do that. Yeah, it might fit in there, but you're going to cause more stress on the pad anyway. Whereas I can just go in there with the 1-inch or put on the 3-inch. It means I can also get in these areas here, and then we'll leave this one for the bigger areas. I might actually do this area with the hybrid as well. Crack on.
A different sense when we mean just fooling around, doing it for kicks. So it is fundamental, as a matter of fact, to both the Hindu and the Christian tradition, that the universe is the play of God. But the Christian thinks of it in the terms of construction play, like building with blocks. And the Hindu thinks of it as dramatic play, of the actual participation of the Godhead in the creation, so that every being...
So while I'm here, I'm going to quickly address the exhaust tips. There's no point in me just passing them and forgetting it later, basically. I'm going to take 2 minutes. They're brand new, so I'm not going to take too much work, and I'd rather get it out of the way.
Being whatsoever is God in disguise.
Nice shiny exhaust tips ready to go for the road.
Or it is expressed in also in the formula tat tvam asi. Colloquially translated, you're it. Or tat, that, tuvam, Latin tuam, you, asi, ah. You are that, that thou art. Tat, of course, is the first word uttered by a baby. Da, 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 da. And fathers flatter themselves that it's saying da-da. It's not. It's saying that. Da, 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 da. The sound water is undrinkable. But it points to the drinkable reality. When you say, though, what is...
So, we've got some water etching around the John Cooper Works badge on the rear. We're going to try and cut into that as best we can with the hybrid. Hopefully, they're not too deep and they do come out.
He's not being correct. Because what you're pointing at is not the noise water. So it's not water. It's that. Da. And water's a kind of jazz. And it's just doing that. And you can get to see, too, people are a kind of jazz. They talk and communicate with each other, but what does that mean? Well, they get together and they make more people and they do this and they do that and they eat and they go on doing this jazz, but it's just jazz. You begin to see, as you do that, everything's like music, you see. It's all...
There we go. I've just cut around the badge all the way into the right angle. Just there. We've got a couple of ticks still, but... That's looking much, much better. All the way out to the tip there. Yeah. So, moving on to the black plastics. These are quite damaged. Hopefully they're going to come up almost like new. I'm going to work some combinations, see what I can do with them. There's a really big mark there on the edge. But yeah, I'll try some combinations and come back. So, I only needed one combination, and that was the same as what I've done on the paintwork, which is the Kartek 9000 and the white pad. That has brought these up fantastically in one stage. You've got a couple of ticks still. I might just go over and do a second pass on that one. But yeah, so much better. So much more clarity in them. Yeah, amazing. So it's polished, it's refined. I'll just turn that off. Yeah, polished, refined, panel white, and now it's ready for Ceramic Pro Primer. So this is the primer layer for 9H or top coat, either one. It just helps the coating adhere better. You can also see much better where you've been, avoid high spots, etc. So yeah, I'm gonna crack on.
There's complicated vibrations. In all kinds of ways. That's that. Or thatness. Ta-ta-ta. Also called in Sanskrit. So anyway, this is the fundamental notion that you are really what there is. The works. Only you're playing hide and seek with yourself. And on a stupendous scale. But if you say hung sa hung sa hung sa hung, it becomes sa hung sa hung sa a hung. That means sa means that the truth a hung. I am that. It's like imagine.
So we've got the Ceramic Pro Nano Primer laid down. I'm going to leave that for about 10 minutes before I start to look at applying the ceramic, just to make sure it's going to give the best adhesion for the coating possible. So, Ceramic Pro 9H, going on the mini. As always, sealed box, a bit like an iPhone unboxing. Which you'll get all your little bits. This is a professional only coating. You cannot buy this as a consumer off the street. You have to be accredited for it. So this is the difference between some detailers. Some detailers use coatings that can be bought off the shelf at any detail retail outlet or whatever. I have to order mine through an accredited shop.
When we get to the final moment in which the world is blown up. You know, imagine the countdown. This is the end. Somebody's pushed the button. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Thank you. and you can sit and listen to the little waves on the seashore. And you get back here into this kind of thinking, and you're hearing the ocean of the universe going. And that's your breathing too. It's all one rhythm. So that when the world is first manifested, as in those dreams that I were mentioning to you, the world is in a golden age to begin with. It's perfect. And that is the longest period of time. Then when we get a little bit more adventurous, you see, the Treta means that in this era, a kind of disharmonious element enters into things. It's like a three-legged chair isn't so secure as a four-legged chair. It's just a bit inclined to tip. And as it were, as a fly in the ointment, a snake in the garden. Then comes Dvapara, in which the forces of good and evil are equally balanced. And finally, Kali, which is the shortest period, where the forces of evil are triumphant, and the world is destroyed at the end of it. For then the Godhead appears in the form of Shiva, who represents the destructive aspect of the divine energy, and whereas Brahma is the creative, Vishnu the preserver, Shiva the destroyer. But Shiva is always the destroyer in the sense of the liberator, the guy who breaks up the ruts. And he comes on with a blue body and 10 arms and a necklace of skulls.
Good morning, guys. So, day 3 of the JCW detail. We've done the wash, we've done the polishing, we've done the first coating. Wheels are off, they're gonna be coated today. I'm gonna put top coat on once I've been around, double checked I've not got any high spots. If I have, I will address them and go from there. Yep, top coat next, and then wheels, calipers coated, wheels back on, tires dressed, and windows coated, and she's done. So I'm just gonna go around, clean the glass with Spotless from Infinity Wax, just to get rid of any residues before we put the glass treatment on.
Indian gods have many arms because they are cosmic centipedes. They do all things without having to think about it, like the centipede doesn't have to think about how to manipulate its legs, like you don't have to think how to grow your hair. And as Shiva dances what is called the Tandava, which is the dance of destruction at the end of the cycle, at the end of the Kalpa, you will see that his hands contain clubs and knives and bells, but one hand is like that. And that gesture means don't be afraid. It's a big act. It is all, as it were, the outflowing of your own consciousness, of your own mind. Now then, the Hindu life is related to this cosmology. And the objective of life is, of course, in the end, to wake up from the dream when you've had enough. And so the dreaming process is called sometimes samsara. Samsara is the round, the rat race. And samsara is divided into six divisions. I better draw a map, I think. This is common, you see, in cosmology to both the Hindus and the Buddhists. This is the world of the Deva. And this is the same root from which we get both divine and devil. The Deva means angel. The highest and most successful beings in the universe. And so opposite, this is the world of Naraka, who are the most unsuccessful. These are the purgatorial worlds of extreme suffering. This is the world of Asura. They are also angels, but they're angry angels, representing the wrath potential of energy. This is the world of animals. This is the world of Preta, for which we have no English equivalent. They are hungry or frustrated spirits who have enormous stomachs but mouths only the size of needles. Vast appetite and no means of fulfillment. And this is the Manu world, that is to say, the world of man. You don't have to take this literally. You could say, when you are extremely happy or ecstatic, you're here. When you are miserable, you're here. When you're dumb, you're here. When you're mad, you're here. When you're frustrated, you're here. But when you're more or less your normal, rational self, you're here. Now, so all life through the period of the kalpas goes grinding around this wheel. And if you go up and you succeed and you get to the top, you have to come down. They don't see success, in other words, in the world as a method of liberation, because it implies failure. So the idea of liberation, which is called moksha, is the ideal of Hindu life. Wake up, it's a dream. And in time, there is no hope in time. Everything is going to get worse in time. Because, as you know, it does. We all fall apart in the end. Everything falls apart. Institutions, buildings, nations, it all crumbles. And people say, well, that's an awfully pessimistic philosophy. Well, is it? I would rather say that the people who have hope in the future are the miserable people. Because they're like donkeys chasing carrots that are dangled before their noses from sticks attached to their collars. And they pursue and they pursue in vain, always hoping that tomorrow will be the great thing, and therefore incapable of enjoying themselves today. People who live for the future never get there, because when their plans mature, they are not there to enjoy them. They're the sort of people who spend their lives saving for their old age, trying to teach their children to do the same thing, so that when they retire at 65, you know, they have false teeth and wrinkles and prostate trouble and all that sort of thing. Where were you going? What did you think it was all about? Furthermore, the fact that life is transient is part of its liveliness. The poets, in speaking of the transience of the world, always utter their best poetry. You know, our revels now are ended. These, our actors, as I foretold you, are all spirits and are melted into air, into thin air.
So, ready for top coat. I'm going to be using 10 mil sprayed on with the airbrush. 10 mil is all it'll take for the full car. including wheels and calipers. I've already coated those. So yeah, we'll crack on.
And like the baseless fabric of this vision, the cloud-capped towers, the gorgeous palaces, the solemn temples, the great earth itself, I, all which it inherits, shall dissolve. And like this insubstantial pageant faded, leave not a wreck behind. We are such stuff as dreams are made of. And said so well, it doesn't seem so bad after all, does it? You see, there's always in the poetry of evanescence a kind of funny nostalgia. Moralists will say, those lovely lips which you so delight to kiss today will in a few years rot and disclose the grinning teeth of a skull. So what? The skull says, lying in the grass, chattering finch and waterfly are not merrier than I. Here among the flowers I lie, laughing everlastingly. No, I may not tell the best. Surely, friends, I could have guessed. Death was but the good king's jest. It was hid so carefully. And monks used to keep skulls on their desks. And people nowadays think that was very morbid. I went and visited a chapel in the Via Veneto in Rome, where there's a crypt where all the altar furnishings are made out of human bones. The altars are piles of skulls. There are rib bones arranged across the ceiling like floral patterns, with vertebrae representing flowers. And they're all dead Capuchin monks. And there's a funny little monk collecting the admissions up at the top. And he has one of the funniest grins on his face I've seen in a long time. I said to him, you know, on the day of resurrection, there's going to be an awful lot of scuttling up this narrow staircase. People trying to reassemble their bones. Oh, dear Father, isn't that my fifth metatarsal? The whole idea, you see, is that everything's falling apart. So don't try and stop it. When you're falling off a precipice, it doesn't do you any good to hang on to a rock that's falling with you. See? But everything is doing that. And so, again, this is another case of our completely wasting our energy in trying to prevent the world from falling apart. Don't do it. And then you'll be able to do something interesting with the free energy. So that's moksha. Because when the Hindu says everything is unreal, the Westerner reacts and says, no, you can't treat life as a dream. It's serious, it's real, it's for real. What do you mean by that? How real do you want it to be? This is, in other words, everything, insofar as it's falling apart, everything is changing. It is like smoke. And we all feel that smoke has a lesser degree of reality than wood. It's an image of the evanescent, of the ghostly. So there's this idea, the whole world is this mirage. That doesn't mean it's a bad thing. It's only bad if you cling to it, if you try to lean on it. But if you don't lean on it, it's a grand illusion. So the word Maya, and it means not only illusion, but it means art, it means magic, and it means creative power. So this is the big act. And it's perhaps easier to feel the world in that way in a tropical country where death is very common, and where you just watch things dissolve before your eyes and yet burst out and grow again. The whole world is changing. Maybe easier to think that way than in our environment. Although when you're out in California, the human landscape changes so fast. that no town is the same for 2 years. Any mailing list that you have changes 1/3 addresses per annum. Nothing stays put. The hills are shadows and they flow from form to form. Nothing stands. Now, this, you see, is not a pessimistic attitude, therefore, at all. To be able to realize that this world is simply a dream, a dancing play of smoke. Fascinating, yes, but don't lean on it. Life is a bridge, says one of the Hindu sayings. Pass over it, but build no house upon it. And so immediately you see that, this is responsible for the enormous gaiety of certain Hindu sayings. This is a thing that often puzzles Westerners. The element of, they expected anybody who's an ascetic or a sage or something to be rather miserable, with a glum face. But on the contrary, you take this character who's going around these days, Maharshi Mahesh, he's always laughing. Because he sees through it. He looks on every side, and there is the face of the beloved, of the divinity, in everybody, in every direction, in everything, playing at being you. And you can look down into a person's eyes, way, way in, and you see the self, the eternal divine. And what is so funny, when it puts on an expression, saying, what, me? And the guru, the teacher. When people go to a guru, they get all sorts of funny ideas. Oh, he's looking right through me. He sees me through and through. He knows how awful I am.
So guys, that is the detour complete. If you like the video, just leave a comment down below or whatever you do on YouTube these days. That would be appreciated. And I'll catch you next time.
It's my most secret thoughts. Because he has a funny look in his face. He isn't even interested in your secret thoughts. He's looking straight at the Godhead in you, with a funny expression on his face, which is saying, why are you trying to kid me? Come off it, Shiva, I know who you are. But, and therefore, you see, his role is to gently humor you.